Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup here to talk to you about the basic contents of a neurovascular bundle. And this is exactly what you can see in terms of the learning objective. And you can kind of get an idea of what types of things may be in a neurovascular bundle just by its name. So most structures of the body, so this includes viscera, muscle, skin, etc., need four main things to function properly. They will need a blood supply to provide oxygen and other nutrients. This is achieved through an artery, and you will often see arteries depicted in red, which you can see right here. These structures will need to get rid of low oxygenated blood, and this is achieved through drainage with veins. And you can see a vein right here depicted in blue, so very often depicted in blue in anatomy illustrations. Similarly, the structure will need removal or drainage of other fluids and, say, like cellular debris, which is going to be accomplished through lymphatic vessels. And lymphatics are often depicted in anatomy illustrations in green, which you can see right here. And last, but certainly not least, all structures will need some form of communication with the central nervous system. So either sending signals to or receiving signals from the CNS, and this will be accomplished with a nerve. And nerves are often depicted in yellow in anatomy illustrations. So I know this seems a little goofy to spend some time talking about colors on an illustration, but this color scheme in anatomy illustrations is so standard, and you'll be looking at anatomy illustrations in one way or another throughout your career, so I believe it is time well spent. So these are kind of the four main things that you'll have in a neurovascular bundle and the colors that you'll see them depicted in illustrations. Now, what is super neat about these structures, they will typically travel together wrapped in some form of deep investing fascia, which you can kind of see right here. Recall our discussion of deep fascia in the integumentary system lecture. Typically, say in the case of a skeletal muscle, you will find the neurovascular bundle on the deep side of the muscle. And so very often you have to reflect the muscle or, you know, kind of go through the muscle belly in order to gain access to those structures. So if doing some type of surgery where you need to get to that, you have to have an understanding that they're very typically located deep to a muscle. Excellent. So that is the very basics of a neurovascular bundle and your first introduction into structures that we will be discussing throughout the year. As always, thank you for your time and attention with these.